Hello students, in this part we are going to learn about eddy currents. So here we are starting with the new topic which is called eddy current. If you see this word eddy, okay, this eddy word has come from the word eddies, okay. What is this eddy? Eddy, if you will see, this is, we can understand that is something which is whirling. Eddies you have observed when the washing machine is rotating. Even you have seen if something is stuck in the sink and if you will remove that particular thing from the sink, you will find that the water is forming a circulating, the water started flowing in a circulating manner. Or you can understand this eddies, like in Hindi if I will say, it is bhavar. Okay. Now how this word for the current, current we already know, the flow of electron. How this current can be as an eddy we are going to see. Okay. This word eddy current has given by the scientist who has discovered, or the physicist who has discovered this. His name is Foucault. He discovered this eddy current in 1895. Okay. And this current is also called a Foucault's current. Now we are going to start demonstrating and start understanding what is this eddy current is. Okay, it's a theory topic, but we are going to only understand its concept. So we are going to begin with its first experiment. Okay. So here you are seeing that I have made the diagram for experiment one. What is here you can see is that what has Foucault has observed when he was performing this experiment, he has observed one thing. What he has observed, that this is here you can see that we took a solenoid, okay, and that solenoid is connected to an AC source. Now what is this AC source? Alternating current. Because when the current is changing, then only we have what we find, that the magnetic flux will induced in the circuit. Because of the change, or the change in the polarity of the current, we found that here, because of the flowing, right? Because of the flow of electron, or because of the moving electrons, or the flow of current, we have observed that it will induce a magnetic field also, right? It will start producing a magnetic field. When the magnetic field is also there, so obviously the magnetic field, if we will consider that the current is entering from this part and leaving from this part, it means here the current is flowing in a clockwise direction. If the current is flowing in a clockwise direction, it means the point where it is entering, so it will be south, and where it is leaving, it will be a north, like that if we will consider, for example. So what will happen, that the here also we found that the current started flowing in this disc. Why it is so? Because when the current started flowing in it, it will produce a magnetic field, and that will get induced, and there we can find that the magnetic field is also produced in this metallic disc. Here if it is a south pole, so here also we can observe that the south polarity is observed. Here you can see this is happening because of the Faraday's first law. And as the south pole is developed here, because of here the south pole we have, so obviously here also it will have a south pole. It means we have observed that when the two same poles are existing, it means they both are repelling. So this starts jumping. This disc will starts jumping, right? And this jumping disc is only gives the rise to the current, which we called an eddy current. When we have keep a disc over it, we have noticed that initially there is no magnetic field, no current in that disc. But once the current started building in it, we have observed that similarly, because of the flowing current, or because of the current, there is a magnetic field. And when the magnetic field is there, so obviously the field lines are changing. So the flux length, flux changes, and because of the change in the flux, the current is get induced in it. And because of this induced current, we found that the same polarity is induced on the disc also. And because of the same pole, they get start repelling each other. And this is only we have observed, and this is the effect of your eddy current. Now we are going to see its second experiment. Okay, in that what we are going to consider is, we are going to take the two bar magnets, and in between two bar magnets we are going to place a slot or a metallic frame of rectangular shape. Now in the second experiment, what we have considered, that we took a bar magnet in which we have kept this in a uniform magnetic field. Okay, so Here, this is a pendulum. What we took? We took a pendulum which is of rectangular shape. Okay. And this is metal plate. Nothing but a metal plate. When this pendulum starts moving, how the pendulum will swing? This way, right? The pendulum starts swinging. We have noticed that when the pendulum is swinging in the presence of uniform, or we can say in the presence of magnetic field, what we have seen? That it shows the damping effect. It shows the damping effect. What is this damping effect is? See, you have seen in grade 11 the pendulum experiment. You have noticed after some time this pendulum, if it is moving at initially at this point, then later it will come to this, and then it will comes to its resting position. Here we have noticed, once we have given an external force we have given to this, or we have seen that by any source we have start moving this pendulum, we have noticed that here the damping got increased. Why it got increased? Because when this pendulum is moving outside and when it is coming inside, what happens every time when it is entering, we have noticed that the current developed in it in a anti-clockwise direction, and when it is moving out, the current is developing in an clockwise direction. It means when this metallic frame is moving outward, that time we have noticed that the south polarity is there, and when it is moving inward, we have noticed that we have a north polarity in it. It means what happens, because of the same pole, it automatically comes to rest. Now, this is because of the eddy current. Okay. Now, what we have done in the same experiment, we took a magnet, but now this time we have noticed, or we took a slotted frame. When we took a slotted frame, what we have observed that now the damping is got reduced. Okay, we have seen that the eddy current will be there, but the damping got reduced. Why the damping got reduced, beta? Because here you will see that eddy current kya hai? Eddy current is a circulating current, right? Eddy current is a circulating current. So, yahan pe eddy current ke liye area kya ho gaya? Zyada ho gaya. That it has to cover the major area, then only it will be changing its polarity. So, we have noticed when we used a slotted ring or a slotted metallic plate, that damping effect is reduced. So, now damping and the eddy current is clear to you. Now, we are going to see and we are going to discuss that why this eddy current is an undesirable effect, or what is the undesirable effect of your eddy current, we are going to discuss. Okay. Now, we are going to discuss that is what is the undesirable effect of the eddy current. Okay. See, if you will see that this eddy current is set up where? This eddy current will set up inside the iron core. Okay. Now, where we have this iron cores, beta? This iron cores, you can notice that class 10th, we have discussed about the rotating motor and generator and all. See, this armature is having the iron core, okay? And we have seen in the electric motors, right? Electric motors, generators and transformers. What happens, because of this generation of this eddy current, we have observed that it produces what? It produces as a unnecessary heating effect. It producing what? It producing an heating effect. Okay. It producing an heating effect which causes an excessive power loss. Okay. So, this is the undesirable effect of the eddy current. But this undesirable effect of eddy current we have used as an application which we are going to discuss. How we can minimize this? We can minimize this eddy current by using a लेमिनेटेड कोर. नाउ व्हाट इज दिस लेमिनेटेड? आपने देखा था कि जो हमारे पास आर्मेचर था, दैट इज ऑफ रेक्टेंगुलर शेप, ऐसा होता था, राइट? एंड इन दिस वी हैव अ नंबर ऑफ वाइंडिंग, करेक्ट? नाउ इफ वी विल यूज एन इंसुलेटिंग मटेरियल दैट कैन बी लाइक अ लेमिनेटेड कोर, मीन्स यू कैन सी दैट विद द हेल्प ऑफ एनी प्लास्टिक, नॉट प्लास्टिक बट बेसिकली वी आर यूजिंग अ सम पैकिंग मटेरियल वी आर यूजिंग, सो दैट कैन बी लेमिनेटेड. ओके, जैसे आप अपनी मार्कशीट को लेमिनेट कराते हो, सिमिलरली वी हैव यूज अ लेमिनेटेड कोर, सो दैट विल if reduce the effect or heating effect and the losses in the transformer core and the electric motor and generator core, heat loss will be minimized. Now, here we are going to see that what is this application of your eddy currents. So, eddy currents have number of applications. So, first one is that what is the good thing about eddy current, beta? Jo iska undesirable effect hai. Undesirable effect kya hai eddy current ka? That it produces in heating effect. It is used in induction furnace. Induction furnace, basically they are using for melting the metal. So when we, in a small amount of current, when we are flowing through any of the conductor and when we are going to keep that metal over it, so because of the excessive heat will produce, the metal get easily melt down because of its undesirable effect. Electromagnetic damping, where we want to stop the function of anything. For example, when the pendulum is rotating, we have used the same effect of eddy current and we have seen that the damping effect is there. If the same we are using in a deadbeat galvanometer. In the previous video, we have discussed about the functioning of the galvanometer. Galvanometer kya hota hai? Aise move karta rehta, right? So, it's immediately come to its deflection point. This also done with the help of eddy current only, okay? Electric brake. In the trains, you have seen that we are using in electric brakes. When we apply the brake, that time what will happen? That this eddy current will help us to stop the train. Okay, in the speedometer, in the induction motor, in the inductotherapy, and many more applications we have that is related to your eddy current. Now, what is this inductothermy? If I will ask you. Okay, this is the basically a branch which is related to the heat localized tissue on the human body. Okay, this branch is called the inductothermy. Clear? So, these are the whole thing related to your eddy currents, its effect, its experiment and its application. Thank you all.